Hello, boys and girls, and welcome to 5-Minute Bedtime Stories with Miss Elaine. Tonight, I have a brand new book to share with you. I'm very excited about it, and I'm actually going to dedicate it to my friend Jode, because Jode loves dinosaurs. So this book is about a gentleman who walks into a hotel, and all he wants to do is get a good night's rest. But it's not as easy as he thought it would be, so let's find out why. There's a dinosaur on the 13th floor. By Wade Bradford. "Welcome to the Sharemore Hotel," said the bellhop. "You must be Mr. Snore. Let me show you to your room."
"The sooner the better," said Mr. Snore.
"I am very,
very sleepy."
"Here you are," said the bellhop. "Room 104. Sweet dreams, Mr. Snore." Mr. Snore thanked the bellhop, got ready for bed, crawled under the covers, and switched off the light. But as soon as he was about to lay his head upon the pillow, he heard a squeaking sound. "Hello, front desk. This is Mr. Snore in room 104. Somebody's sleeping on my pillow." "Yes, that would be the mouse," said the bellhop. "I believe he's had a very long day."
"So have I," grumbled Mr. Snore, "and I do not wish to share a room with a mouse."
So the bellhop led Mr. Snore to a room on the second floor. "Sleep tight, Mr. Snore." Mr. Snore crawled into bed and switched off the light, but just as he was about to fall asleep, he felt a rush of cold air. Mr. Snore called the front desk again. "Someone is hogging all the covers."
"That would be Pig," said the bellhop. "Shall I bring you another blanket?"
"No," Mr. Snore fumed. "I want another room." The bellhop took Mr. Snore to the third floor, where there were no pigs or mice to be found. Mr. Snore kicked off his slippers, crawled into bed, and was just about to close his eyes when, drip, drip, drip. "Sorry about the leaky ceiling," the bellhop said as Mr. Snore marched past the ocean view of the fourth floor. "This time," declared Mr. Snore, "I will find my own room." So he found one. On the fifth floor.
"I don't think you'll like this room," whispered the bellhop. "Unless, of course, you are very fond of..."
"Spiders!" cried Mr. Snore.
"Quick," said the bellhop, "to the elevator."
"How do you feel about bees?" said the bellhop.
"The same way I feel about spiders," said Mr. Snore. "Please skip the sixth floor."
Well, the seventh floor was too hot. The eighth floor was too cold. The ninth floor was just...
"Giraffes?" cried Mr. Snore.
The bellhop smiled. "Would you care to guess what's on the 10th floor?" On the 10th floor, they found... What do you think? Did they find the rest of the giraffe? Because his really long neck would also reach up to the 10th floor? Do you think? They found...
"Hamsters!"
"Where are the rest of the giraffes?" asked Mr. Snore.
"On the 11th floor," said the bellhop.
"Then I will stay on the 12th, said Mr. Snore. So they went to the 12th floor.
"Hey, it's empty," said Mr. Snore.
"No one ever stays here," explained the bellhop.
"Perfect," said Mr. Snore, and he lay down and shut his eyes.
"It does tend to get a bit noisy," the bellhop warned, but Mr. Snore was already fast asleep. So he didn't even hear his warning. He is fast asleep. But listen. Stomp, 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 gurgle, gurgle, swish, swish. Stomp, 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 gurgle, gurgle, swish, swish. What is that noise? And where do you think it's coming from?
Mr. Snore rang the front desk. "I cannot sleep with all this noise. I'm going to find a room on the 13th floor."
"Oh dear, no," said the bellhop. "On the 13th floor, there is a..." Click. It was too late. He had already hung up. Mr. Snore did not wait to hear the bellhop's warning, and he went up to the 13th floor. There were no mice, no pigs, no penguins, no snakes, no spiders, no dolphins, no bees, and no giraffes. Not even a hint of a hamster. Nothing but a giant room with a giant bed and a giant pillow. Has Mr. Snore finally found the perfect room?
I do hope Mr. Snore will be all right, said the bellhop. Pring, went the phone at the front desk again. Hello, this is the dinosaur on the 13th floor. Somebody is sleeping on my pillow. The bellhop sighed. That would be Mr. Snore, he said. He's had a very long day. Uh-oh, look, the dinosaur came out from the bathroom. He was in there brushing his teeth. And he came out to find Mr. Snore in his bed. And so what does he do? The dinosaur has to go down and sleep in the hotel lobby. Because Mr. Snore was already fast asleep. The end. What did you think, boys and girls? Was that a silly story? All those animals in the hotel and the great big dinosaur on the 13th floor that Mr. Snore never even saw, huh? All right, let's sing our lullabies together, and we're going to start with Twinkle, Twinkle, Little Star. Do you remember the signs I taught you for it? Can we sing it in sign language? This is Twinkle, Twinkle. This is Little Star. Try to do just at least that part with me at home. Twinkle, twinkle, little star, how I wonder what you are. Up above the world so high, like a diamond in the sky. Twinkle, twinkle, little star, how I wonder what you are.
Excellent job, boys and girls. And now we're going to sing the moon lullaby.
I see the moon and the moon sees me. God bless the moon and God bless me.
And God bless all of you boys and girls at home. Thank you so much for watching. And I'll see you again soon on 5-Minute Bedtime Stories with Miss Elaine. Good night.